Hi everyone, I'm going to discuss about the structure of cancer cell. First of all, we have to know what is cancer. The cancer is a disease of uncontrolled cell division. It is the term cancer is derived from the Latin word cancrum, which means the crab. The cancer is a disease which is caused by the uncontrolled cell division. The cancer cells will divide rapidly, which leads to the overgrowth of the cells. And it is also called as a tumor. An abnormal overgrowth causes the enlargement of the tissues. Its development and progressions are usually linked to the series of changes in the activity of the cell cycle regulator. A cancer cells will grow out of control manner, but the normal cells, their growth can be temporarily ceases by means of senescence, that is aging process, and also the cell can also undergo the organized as well as the programmed cell death process like apoptosis. Unlike the normal cells, the cancer cells will ignore the signals which stop the cell division. However, the cancer cells, the control mechanism have also gone away, which leads to them to grow in out of control fashion. They divide repeatedly and the growth out of control, hence the cells became enlarged and it appears like a tumor. Let us see the structure of cancer cells. Morphologically, the cancer cells are characterized by large nucleus which are having irregular shape as well as in the size, and they are also having a prominent nucleoli. Their size also enlarged, hence the enlargement of the nucleus and the nucleolus causes the cytoplasm to reduce in size. So the cytoplasm is very scarce in the cancer cells when compared to the normal cells, and it is also intensely colored, or they may be pale in appearance. Next, coming to the chromosomal abnormality, the cancer cells generally gain multiple types of chromosomal abnormality, that is during the tumor progression process. They including the deletion, duplication, and even rearrangements. So as a result of this, the genome became progressively more unstable, and this is due to the abnormal mitosis. Next, coming to the centrioles, the centrioles also behaving misbehaving in the cancer cells, and which is one of the characteristic feature of the cancer cells. The mitosis are characteristics of the malignant cells. The number of mitoses also increases, and typically the mitosis forms with the defects in the mitotic spindle fibers will appear, and which results in triple or quadruple asters and dissymmetrical structures and an atypical form of the chromosomes. So in cancer cells, the two centrioles are separated by random distances. The centrioles, which are the microtubules, they became abnormal in cancer cells. They are enlarged, and they also do not have any connecting fine structures in cancer cells. The cancer cells often have extra as well as longer centrioles, which are absent in the normal cells. Then in the plasma membrane, it is the most visible property of the cancer cell, that is their invasiveness to the other tissues. It is primarily a property of the plasma membrane, and it became leaky, hence the content in the cell became spread to the next cell. So they also begin to grow as a cancer cells. So the cancer cell can release an excessive amount of the growth promoting factor, and they escape by leakage through the cell membranes, and even it acts on the surface of the neighboring cells. After it has leaked out, it acts on the surfaces of the neighboring cells, and this will result in dramatic spurt in the growth and the cell multiplication in the normal cells, which also become abnormal in shape and size. The cytoplasm in the cancer cells also undergo changes. Sometimes the new structures will appear, the normal structures may also disappear, and the accumulation of some of the ribosomal DNA, RNA, or the messenger RNA in the cytoplasm makes them basophilic. The malignant cells have a small cytoplasmic amount, which are frequently with the vacuoles. Then the endoplasmic reticulum, like granular endoplasmic reticulum, as the appearance of the simplified structures, and they became also reduced. The amorphous granules of filamentous materials can accumulate in the cistern, and the fragmentation and degranulations are frequently found in the cancer cells. Then the Golgi apparatus in the malignant cells is also poorly developed, which involves a positive correlation with the lack of the tumor cell differentiation. Then mitochondria decreases in their volume with the tumor development. The mitochondria show a high variability of the shape and volume, and the huge mitochondria can be sometimes absorbed in the cancer cells. In lysosomes, which also undergo changes in the process of cell malignizations, the secondary lysosomes, which is myelinic structures and lipofuscin granules, will appear in cancer cells. From this figure, we can also understand the difference between the structure of normal cell and the cancer cells. The normal cells are elliptical or round in shape, but the cancer cells are irregular in shape as well as in their size. Then the normal cells are having larger amount of cytoplasm around the nucleus, but in the cancer cells, the cytoplasm became reduced, and the nucleus is there is a single nucleus with a spheroid shape in the normal cells, but in cancer cells, there are multiple nuclei and they are in irregular shapes. And the normal cells also having a single nucleolus, but in the cancer cells, multiple nucleolus are there. Here the fine chromatin is present in the normal cells, but in the cancer cells, coarse chromatins are present. The normal cells grows in controlled manner, but the cancer cells will grow in an uncontrolled fashion. And thank you for watching.